12 o'clock is Leticia Nieto Juarez or Soledad Nieto. And at 5 p.m. is Florida Parish. If y'all would please stand and welcome Father Rodney White.
To those that ever endure. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God forever and ever.
Amen.
A reading from the first book of Kings. The Lord appeared to Solomon in a dream at night. God said, "Ask something of me, and I will give it to you." Solomon answered, "O Lord my God, you have made me your servant, king to succeed my father David. But I am a mere youth, not knowing at all how to act. I serve you in the midst of the people whom you have chosen, a people so vast that it cannot number or count. Give your servant, therefore, an understanding heart to judge your people and to distinguish right from wrong. For who is able to govern this vast people of yours?" The Lord was pleased that Solomon made his request. So God said to him, "Because you have asked for this, and not for a long life for yourself, nor for riches, nor for the life of your enemies, but for understanding so that you may know what is right, I do as you requested. I give you a heart so wise and understanding that there has never been anyone like you up to now. And after you, there will become no one to equal you." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The response for today is, "Lord, I love your commands." I have said, O Lord, that my part is to keep your words. The law of your mouth is for me more precious than thousands of gold and silver pieces.
Lord,
let your kindness comfort me, according to your promise to your servants. Let your compassion come to me that I may live, for your law is my delight. For I love your commands more than gold I ever find. For in all your precepts I go forward, every false way I hate.
Lord, I love your commands.
Wonderful are your decrees, therefore I observe them. The revelation of your word sheds light, giving understanding to the simple. Lord, I love your commands. The second reading is from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, we know that all things work for good for those who love God, who are called according to his purpose. For those he foreknew, he also predestined to become conformed to the image of his Son, so that he might be the firstborn among many brothers and sisters. And those he predestined, he also called. And those he called, he also justified. And those he justified, he also glorified. The word of the Lord.
Thanks.
Thank you.
buried in a field, which a person finds and hides again. And our story goes and sells all that he has, buys that field. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like immersion, searching for fine pearls. When he finds a pearl of great price, he goes and sells all that he has and buys it. Again, the kingdom of heaven is like a net thrown into the sea, which collects every kind of fish. When it is full, they call it ashore, and sit down to put what is good into buckets. What is bad, they throw away. Thus it will be at the end of the age. The angels will go out and separate the wicked from the righteous, and throw them into the fiery furnace, where there will be wailing and grinding of teeth. Do you understand all these things? They answered, yes. And he replied, then every scribe who has been instructed in the kingdom of heaven is like the head of a household who brings from his storeroom both the new and the old. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
In reflecting on this weekend's readings, I kept thinking back to a scene from an old movie, some of which you may have seen, called A Christmas Story, in which the main character, Ralphie, is listening to a radio program in which it is advertised a secret decoder ring. A secret decoder ring, and then they would give the secret code. And so Ralphie takes a lot of time to save up money to get this decoder ring. And then he has to wait 8 to 12 weeks, 2 to 3 months, which I don't know about you, but for a little kid waiting on a prize, it's a long time. And when he finally gets the decoder ring, he can't wait for the radio show to come back on Saturday night. And that Saturday night, he's writing down the numbers. And he's writing them down. And he takes out his new decoder ring, and he starts figuring it out, the code. Drink more Ovaltine. And Ralphie is so dismayed. He's so disgusted. He throws away the ring. He had put everything on this ring. He had listened to the hype. He had heard the advertising that was telling him about how important it was for him to have this secret decoding ring. And then all he gets is another commercial. Our gospel tells the parable of the pearl of great price, of the merchant looking for pearls. This is the man's livelihood. And when he finds the pearl of great price, he sells everything that he has to go and purchase that pearl. It is hitting the mother lode. It is finding that perfect thing. And it is worth everything. So much so that he sells all that he owns. Now, I don't know about you, but I think for me to sell everything that I own would require quite a bit. And within this, it tells us something about the nature of the kingdom of God. The very nature of the kingdom of God is that pearl of great price. That which we are looking for throughout our lives, doing, our day-to-day thing. And that when we encounter it, we do whatever is necessary to seek it out. And yet, how many of us are not chasing pearls, but other things? How many of us are facing off with the rampant consumerism in our country? Like little Ralphie, hearing how important that decoder ring is and putting our everything into that. Except for us, it's not a decoder ring. Maybe it's a house, or a car, a drug, a relationship, or any number of other things that we go chasing after. It is like being that merchant of pearls who goes out seeking not fine pearls, but knickknacks, junk. Where do we spend our capital? Where do we spend our money? Where do we spend our time? Do we focus ourselves on entertainment? Do we focus ourselves on power in the world? Becoming more powerful? Would we recognize the pearl when we find it? Brothers and sisters, our gospel today calls us to be seeking for the kingdom of God, to be seeking Jesus with all of our hearts and with every effort that we have. And that when we encounter him, we set everything else aside. Because we hear that second part of that parable, that the kingdom of heaven is like the net that is thrown into the sea and is brought up with all sorts of fish, including some that aren't any good for eating. And so we have to make our focus on the kingdom of God, to put our focus on our salvation, put our focus on Jesus himself. For he is that pearl of great price. He is that treasure in the field. He is that which is worth giving up everything that we have and walking away from everything that we find important in our world. Because it means the salvation of our souls. Let us pray in our Mass today for that grace to recognize the Lord when we encounter him, and to respond to his invitation to throw everything else aside and to follow him. Let us stand now to present our needs to the Lord. Let us pray for Francis, our Pope, for Michael, our Bishop, and for all who lead us in the faith, we pray to the Lord. Let us pray for more vocations, a priesthood, and religious life. Let us pray to the Lord. Let us pray for all those who have asked for some prayer from us. Let us pray to the Lord. And for our own needs, which we present to God now in the silence of our hearts. For these, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Almighty God, you know our needs before we ever present them to you. We ask that you grant them if they be according to your will, and we ask this through Jesus our Lord.
Amen.
Now let's actually pray our creed. I believe in one God, the Father, the Almighty, maker of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before. God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us men and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was incarnate of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, who was crucified under Pontius Pilate, he suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended to heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who with the Father and the Son is adored and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets. I believe in one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church. I confess one baptism for the forgiveness of sins, and I look forward to the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen. And at this time, you can bring your collection forward as we prepare the altar.
Thank you.
to your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts that we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. For on the night he was betrayed, he himself took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Therefore, O Lord, as we celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven, and as we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognizing the sacrificial victim, by whose death you willed to reconcile us to yourself, grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one Spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so that we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Stephen and with all the saints on whose constant intercession in your presence, we rely for unfailing help. May the sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and the salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Michael, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. To our departed brothers and sisters, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kindness to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him, with him, and in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord,
I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed. Let's pray. We have consumed, O Lord, this divine sacrament, the perpetual memorial of the passion of your Son. Grant, we pray, that this gift, which he himself gave us with love beyond all telling, may profit us for salvation through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth.
Go forth, Maxine.
Thanks be to God.